Hey guys, okay, I'm gonna walk you through how to do color separation in your artwork in Photoshop. So far in this project, you guys all watercolored something and you brought it into Photoshop, cleaned it up a little bit, you even put it into repeat. So now our next step that we're gonna focus on is separating the colors. So the idea is that this would go out to a printer and a printer's gonna have to, you have to set up a setup fee for each colorway. And if you're doing these roller printers, they're these like big metal things with like engraved holes in it for your artwork. They're really expensive to set up. So it's usually best to have as least amount of colors as possible. I don't know, just depending what you're willing to pay. If it was screen printing, then they would burn flat screens. There's lots of different ways to do it. But at the end of the day, you usually need your colors separated unless you're printing direct to garment. We're gonna separate the colors. So this is how you do it. You'll start up, you go to image mode, and most likely the RGB color's checked, maybe CMYK is checked. But to separate the colors, we are going to index the colors, okay? After we manually index them, then you'll notice that color table won't be grayed out and you'll have a color table. And actually at the end of this project, you're gonna wanna screenshot your color table and share it with the class. Don't forget to do that. Okay, so let's index a color. This is the hard work. So here we go. Okay, right off the bat, it's saying you have multiple layers. So it needs to be flat. So I'm gonna say okay. You might wanna save, you know, the file with lots of layers and then save a new one with the flat layers just in case you ever need to go back for whatever reason. Okay, so we have the index color window up. It has lots of different options here. I play around with it. I usually end up doing local selective or perceptual. You can play around with it as well. I've never tried the Mac one. That's kind of new. Maybe I'll try the Mac one today. Mac's not gonna work because it's not letting me change the colors. It's saying it has to have 256. So I'm gonna go back to, I guess I'll do selective. We can't have 256 colors. That's just gonna be way too expensive. So I would love, like, how many colors do you guys think? I see we got dark blue, we got like turk, and we have like purple. I'm not gonna count the white because that could just be the fabric. But you could throw it in just for your index. That's like four colors. But then maybe you want, you know, two shades of each of those colors. Maybe you want three shades. That's nine. I think it'd be great if we can get this down to 10 colors. That would be great. So right now I actually typed in 26. There's a preview. I'm going to uncheck it. Do you guys notice a difference? I should probably zoom in. I'm going to say cancel. Let's see if I can zoom in here. Be a little closer. Okay, so image mode, index color. Okay, 26, I'm gonna uncheck preview. You know, I mean, obviously we're losing some colors here. So if you're worried about losing, you could type in a higher number like 33 maybe. Let's preview that. I don't notice a huge change with 33. So I mean, you could do 33 and just manually change them the way you want. Or you can go down to like, let's say I want a 10, right? What if I hit 10? You know, or just trust the computer. Most designers don't always love trusting the computers, usually want a little bit more control. What if I type in 30? There we go. Okay, I'm gonna do preview. 33 was better, wasn't it? So this is where you start doing the work. Okay. Oh, no, it's not. Let's see here. I'm going to try 36. Okay, 36 kind of kept the bright. Not really. I don't see a huge difference, actually. Okay, I'm going to go back down to 26. Just kind of playing around here. That's the original. I keep hitting the preview thing to see the difference. What if I pick perceptual? Is there a big difference there? I don't see a huge difference, be honest with you. Adaptive. I just like to play around with it just to see. I'm probably going to stick with selective. Another thing I didn't mention is the forced, you know, make sure that none is checked. That's what I usually do. You also have a dither here. I usually have it on diffusion. What happens if I do none? It's like not grainy enough for mine. So I think for me, the dither should be on diffusion. There you go. So it just kind of blends it a little bit better. For me, let's see, I even have an amount. I could probably play around, change with that. So I mean, you kind of play around, change with it. Like, try to get as close as you can. If you're far away, that's okay too, because, you know, maybe you can fix it on the next leg. So I'm going to say okay. Okay. So I obviously cannot have a 26 color artwork. It's going to be too expensive to print, and let, you know, if I'm being charged per screen. So now we're going to move on to part two, and that is kind of cleaning up the color table. Okay. So to clean up the color table, you go to image, mode, and look, color table is now no longer grayed out. So you click that guy. And these are all 26 colors in my print. So now I can manually combine them myself. So honestly, right off the bat, the first two, those could probably be combined. You know, if you're not too sure, like I'll click one and I'll make it an obnoxious color. Like I'll do like bright red, right? Okay, so that's where it is. It's that shade right there. I'll go back to current, or I'll just say cancel. If I say current, I'm gonna copy it. I copied the ECDFEC color code down here. Now I'll say cancel, and I'm gonna go to the next one, and let's see what that is. Again, I'll pick some annoying color. Maybe I'll just combine those two. So I'm gonna go ahead and paste, Command V. So I pasted the first color. And I'll say, okay. So now these first two color chips are actually the exact same color. And that's the work of the second leg, right? The first challenge is like indexing it kind of automatically. How many colors should I put in? And then once you have it indexed, now you can actually go in and manually combine. So if you want more control of your artwork, you know, I only typed in 26. You might want to type in 50 colors, and then you can manually go in and combine them the way you want. That might be better for you. That's an option. Okay, so this pink, this one pink just might be by itself. I don't know if I'm going to combine it with anyone. No, there it is. I'm just like using an obnoxious color to kind of find it. So for now, I'm just going to say cancel. I'm going to leave you as pink. This purple, what do we got here? I'm just picking, you know, like, I wish it would go to the red. Weird. Okay, that's some, so I'll go back to current. I'm just gonna copy that shade of purple. Okay. Should I make this guy the same purple? I went ahead and pasted it. Okay, so 1, 2. Maybe I'll make this one the same purple. Again, you know, I'm just assuming I might not like this later. I'm just pasting them all because they look similar to me. But again, if I was being more careful, each one, I would probably go up and, you know, kind of evaluate where it is. Do I really want that purple, or should that be like a shade of the navy blue? I don't know. I think I'm going to make it purple. Okay. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Let's see here. Or maybe this should be the new color. Copy. Okay. Maybe I'll go backwards and paste you. There we go. I think that's better. So anyways, you can play with this for a while to get it just right. I really want to get mine to like 10 colors or less. I'm going to say cancel. I might go find this color and copy it. Say okay, and I might go ahead and paste it right here. Okay. So you're going to do the work to get it down. Right now, let's just see how many colors I'm at. I know I should spend time going through, but I'm videoing this and I don't want to bore you guys. So let's just see how I'm doing. I've only finished about halfway. I'm going to say, okay. Now, to kind of reset your color table, you can combine the same colors. And how you'll do that is you're going to go to image, mode, and you're going to switch it back to RGB color. Okay, not a huge change. Then you go image, mode, and switch it back to indexed color. And now you can leave the palette at exact because it's already been indexed once, so you have those exact colors, so you don't have to do anything. And look, it says now we're at 20. So I'll say okay. And now I can go back to the color table. Image, mode, color table, and I can get back to work, right? So I didn't really finish. I can probably combine more of these blues. I wanna keep going until I'm down to just 10 colors. Honestly, so I'll keep doing it. So that's really how you do it. Let's see here. I'm going to say, okay, I know I need to go and get my teals combined and these whites, but for the sake of the video, I'm going to move on to my next point I want to talk about, which is you. After you're done, you can zoom in. And there might be things you don't really like about it. So if there's something you want to change, you can go in manually and recolor it. So like maybe for some reason, you know, maybe for whatever reason, I don't want all these purple dots. You can just go recolor it. So I might use the selection tool. I'm gonna select it. Only purple is selected. And then now I can get like the brush tool. And let's see here. Maybe I wanna change that to like this more like light purple. So I'm gonna hit the eyedropper. I'm gonna eyedrop this light purple. And then I'll get my brush, B for brush. And why is my mouse stuck? There it is. Okay, it's really small. Let's see here. Let me zoom out. Okay. Okay. Let's see here. Let's see what brush we should use. One's really small. Let's make this guy. I mean, you can make it as big as you want. And hardness 100% is fine. Okay, and then, you know, you can go in and brush on top of it and it'll change. I should probably zoom in so you can see this. So it should change all of that that's selected to the color I just eyedropped. So basically what I'm saying is that you can manually go in and recolor this. I like to select a color first so that I'm only changing that one color. But it, honestly, you could even just redraw your artwork if you wanted. If you're like, no, I want that there now. That's fine. Just make sure you're using the colors, like use the eyedropper tool. So you're using the colors that were on your color table. You don't want to add any new colors to this, but you can definitely go in and clean up your artwork if something's just looking funny or you want to change the colors and whatnot. So, all right, guys, I'm excited to see how this color separation activity goes for you and looking forward to seeing your artwork after it's been color separated. Let me know if you guys have any questions as always. Okay.